So hi class, this is homework assignment number 6 on SLAM, and we are going to practice some more questions about the graph SLAM algorithm, and I will ask you something new about how to make graph SLAM more efficient towards the end of this homework assignment. So there's three questions and one new thing, which comes with additional questions and a programming assignment. So let's dive in. In this example, picture a robot that starts at initial position 5. This robot, which lives in 1D, even though I'm drawing this in 2D, sees a landmark with a relative measurement of 2. It then moves to coordinate x1 by taking a step of 7. It now sees a different landmark, L1, with a measurement value of 4. Finally, it moves again with a motion 2. And now it sees the same second landmark, not the original one, at a value of 2. Obviously, when you work it out and solve this, you find that the best coordinates over here are 12 and 14, whereas landmark coordinates are 7 and 16. But none of the numbers I just told you will be inserted in the question I'm about to ask. Picture the matrix omega and the vector c. I want you to add all these constraints into omega, with the caveat that for the initial constraint, I assume the strength is just 1, so enter it the way you're used to. I also assume the motion update has a sigma of 1, but the measurement update, the sigma for measurements, has a value of 0.5. And remember, we weigh those updates with 1 over sigma, which in the measurement case would therefore be 2. I want you to fill in the values for sigma and for C for this specific example. I gave you some of the sigma values and some of the C values, and I want you to fill in the missing values over here. You can check whether you got them correct by verifying that I got those numbers correct. And you can also solve for omega minus 1 times C, and out should come the red positions shown in the diagram over here.